Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Bayer after the company secured a significant legal victory over claims that its Roundup weed killer causes cancer. Bayer shares surged 11% on that news. Also in focus, shares of Mpox vaccine maker Bavarian Nordic. That's after the first case of the new Mpox strain outside of Africa was reported in Sweden. Shares of the Danish biotech firm soared 16%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of U.S. tax preparation company H&R Block, which reported better than expected fourth quarter results and issued upbeat guidance for 2025. The stock jumped 8% in pre-market trading. Asian markets ended Friday trade with gains as solid U.S. economic data eased recessionary fears. Japan's Nikkei 225 led the charge to post its best week in 4 years. The South Korean Kospi Index, which returned from a holiday, jumped 2%. Philippine shares also joined the rally, with the main index rising 2.3%, a day after the Philippine Central Bank slashed its key rates for the first time in nearly 4 years.
Actually, we were expecting some profit taking, no? So after the market has already climbed up the last couple of days, the last 2 weeks, I was actually expecting some sell on the news day to day, but that didn't happen at all. No, okay. That was how strong the market was, despite being already overbought. People were still willing to bid up prices today.
Over in Thailand, the SET index climbed 1% as the country's parliament elected its youngest prime minister, 37-year-old Petronthan Sinawat. She's the daughter of former Thai leader Thaksin Shinawat. Some after-hours economic data from the region. Hong Kong's economy expands by 3.3% in the second quarter from a year earlier. That's faster than the 2.7% growth in the first quarter of 2024. Its government says growth should continue in the remainder of the year. It kept its full-year economic growth target between 2.5% and 3.5%. Hong Kong, a major financial hub, has been struggling to bounce back after a three-year COVID-19 lockdown. Meanwhile, in Taiwan, its statistics authority lowers its growth forecast for the economy, citing weaker-than-expected exports. It now sees GDP expanding by 3.9% this year, just a tad slower than its previous projection of 3.94%. This is as the agency sees exports growing by just 8.71% this year, compared with its earlier forecast of 10.06%. That's despite an AI boom that has boosted demand for tech products. Taiwan's trade-driven economy is a key link in the global technology supply chain for companies such as Apple and NVIDIA. It is home to the world's biggest contract chip maker, TSMC. The Philippine Central Bank sees climate change negatively impacting the country's economy in the long run. In its 2023 sustainability report, the BSP estimated 7.6% of the country's GDP would be affected by damages from climate change by 2030. Now, this number is seen to rise further to 13.6% by 2040. The BSP noted the Philippines incurred over 24 billion pesos in damage due to natural extreme events last year. The BSP also said temperature shocks could drive inflation up by 0.46 percentage points in the short run. Inflationary impacts can go up to 0.79 percentage points across a longer period. Central Bank Governor Eli Remolona Jr. maintains a climate-resilient economy and financial stability are mutually reinforcing outcomes. He vows to unlock finance for adaptation measures towards a whole-of-nation approach to climate resilience efforts.